Okay, new video, layering, building up a breakdown. Now in the last video, you saw how to create a breakdown, how to effectively use your remix kit and blah, 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 blah. You should have watched that video. If not, I implore you to go and buy it because you know, this video is after that section. So if you are watching this video and you've not checked out the first video, you will see me working on all this and see how I build up a remix. Now this video is all about layering. So when you create a remix or when you start with a remix, it's important that you get all your parts in, you get everything sounding great, you mix it. Now you've got two choices then. You can move on to the next section. Now if you follow my 10-step guide, then you will then do the baseline. Or if you want, and excuse me, it's down to you at this point, you can do some layering and you can build up the breakdown a little bit. Now this can be beneficial because I'm gonna make some new counter melodies. I might make some changes to the piano. I might put some effects in there. So, excuse me, what it means is when you come to your bass line when it comes to moving on, you've kind of got some elements already. So you do all your bass line, you do your percussion, you do your mid bass, right? And then, you know, you come on to the next section. When it comes to like melodies and counter melodies and things like that and atmospheres, you've already got something to break down which you've worked on. So it means you've already got a starting point. However, it's down to you. Now, why are we doing a remix? It's very important as a new producer, or at least in my opinion, that you're focused on remixes. Now, don't get me wrong, originals are the be-all and end-all of making it as a producer. You will not get anywhere making remixes full-time. So don't think that I'm saying that you need to do just remixes. However, think of it like this. When you're a new producer, or even an intermediate producer, you're trying to juggle everything. You're trying to learn how to use a DAW, or at least use a DAW. You know, they're complicated. They're not, you know, to people that don't know them, they can be very overwhelming. At the same time, you're trying to understand engineering, compression, reverb, layering, sound selection, a million different things. And on top of that, you're going to write music when you can't even write music. I noticed that with my new clients and me as a young producer, my chord progressions were shit. I didn't understand melodies because I was trying to juggle too many things about. So what I do with my clients, I get them to do remixes. Now what happens is they start a track, we build up a remix, just like you saw in a previous video, and then they follow my 10-step guide. Now, what that means is they've got all the parts in there. Boom, it all sounds amazing. So we don't need to worry about chord progressions, writing leads, understanding arpeggios. This can all come later. It allows them to focus on building up a track and actually understanding how to make music by finishing tracks. So I can't implore you enough to do remixes. And yeah, ask me for my 10-step guide, tutorials at adamlsdj.com.